Labą dieną, gerbiami žurnalistai.
Good afternoon, dear journalists. I'd like to share a few ideas after the informal meeting of the Ministers of Defense with you. This meeting was an excellent opportunity for us to discuss our way forward. The more so that in December, after a five-year break, the European Council will be devoted to the defense issues. Therefore, here in Vilnius, 20 ministers from various member states shared their views on the deliverables of the December summit. Since these deliverables will be decisive for the future of Europe, of its defense. The worrying security situation in the EU neighborhood once again demonstrates that Europe must strengthen the role it plays in ensuring global security. Lithuania believes that a more active involvement of the various partners in the CSDP will allow us to move towards this goal. Our recent partners in numerous meetings have demonstrated their readiness to cooperate with the EU in the area of security and defense, and they would do that by committing their capabilities and sharing experience. During our meeting, ministers and myself said that the December European Council should focus on the future of the battle groups which are there to react to crisis. We have to decide on the future of these battle groups. We suggest more flexible deployment of battle groups so that they can be deployed depending on the nature of crisis. Sometimes maybe part of such group would be activated. At the working dinner, the ministers were briefed on the ongoing operations, EU operations, that is, training mission in Mali, the Atalanta operation, directed against piracy at the Somali coast, and the Altea operation in Bosnia and Herzegovina. The commanders informed us that all these operations are carried out successfully. The number of private attacks went down, the first army battalions have been trained. At the dinner, ministers also exchanged views on the conflict in Syria. However, we agreed that these discussions will continue among the ministers of foreign affairs and that they will be summarized later on after the High Representative. The changing security environment must reshape our thinking and our security priorities too. These priorities must be reflected in our strategic documents. Thus, I believe that if the December European Council tasks us with a renewal of the current strategic security guidelines, this would be a very timely step. Let me now pass the floor to the Deputy Secretary General of the EEAS, Mr. Maciej Popovsky.
Thank you very much, Mr. Minister. Thank you for hosting us here. Indeed, the meeting was very much focused on the preparations for the European Council. It was an opportunity to discuss the interim report of the High Representative, as well as the communication, the July communication of the European Commission on the defense industry. As Cathy said at the end of the meeting, it's important that the Europe's leaders keep an eye on defense, and they should do it in December, but that they should also do it in the future regularly. I think that was also a clear wish of the member states, that the European Council should return to this issue. It should not be a one-off. But we should go about the defense cooperation in a very pragmatic way and think of the specificity of the defense market. In general, the proposals of the High Representative were very well received. We received a lot of support. I think everybody agrees that there is scope for improvement, that we should do better, we should be more rational about defense spending. And of course, while preserving sort of the intergovernmental nature of the defense cooperation in Europe and the competences of all institutions. Complementarity with NATO was stressed and also demonstrated by the presence of Secretary General yesterday, who also praised the report of the High Representative as a very healthy basis, as he called it, for further work. Today, the discussion was very much focused on the Commission's proposals and the potential of the European industry and defense market. Again, it's an important area. Many ministers have referred to the relevance of the industrial bases, including the role of small and medium-sized enterprises in Europe, access to research, I mean, the research in the area of dual use, certification, standardization, so streamlining the way the European industry, defense industry, is operating. And it's all about growth and jobs in Europe. We should bear that that in mind. So, in short, this is the beginning of a very intense period of work leading us to the December European Council. Thank you.
Laikas klausimam. We have a quarter of an hour for questions. Please identify yourself and please state who you are addressing your question to. Vaidai.
Klausimas tiek ministrui, tiek.
A question both to the minister and the representative of Mrs. Ashton. You mentioned Syria. Do the ministers of the EU have a common opinion that the Assad regime is responsible for the chemical attack? And how many EU member states would support the military intervention that is proposed by the US? I will start. As I said, during the working dinner, we have exchanged information on the issue of Syria. And I could sum up our discussions as follows. All member states have denounced the use of chemical weapons. And those responsible for this attack should bear the responsibility. And there are many signs that allow us to conclude that the chemical weapons were used by the regime. However, final conclusions will be presented by Ms. Cathy Ashton after the meeting of ministers of foreign affairs.
The issue will be discussed by foreign ministers who are going to meet in Vilnius today and then tomorrow. So there was agreement that chemical weapons have been used, and it was clearly condemned by everyone. And that's all I can say for the moment. Thank you.
LRT television, Kristina Jackūnaitė. Klausimas taip pat ir po.
I have a question to Mr. Olika and Mr. Popovsky. I have a follow-up question, actually. The intervention, the military intervention, do you think Europe can be united in this intervention?
Tai pirmiausia, kad situacija Sirijoje iš tikrųjų yra sudėtinga.
Yes, the situation in Syria is serious. It has been serious for some time already. And I will repeat myself by saying that there's no single answer to the current situation. That's why we have a variety of views, that's why we exchange opinions and views, and that's why our final decision will be presented to you by the High Representative, as I said, after her meeting with the foreign ministers.
The outcome of the discussion of the foreign ministers, but this will be the most relevant topic on their agenda.
LRytas LT, Vytautas Valentinavičius.
Lithuanian Daily Lietuvos Rytas. The NATO Secretary General said he was concerned that if the defense spending goes down as it's been going down recently, the EU will not be able to take part in any military missions. How this question will be solved in Lithuania? How Lithuanian budget will reflect this criticism? I believe that all the EU ministers of defense are ready to use in a most rational way more financing for defense. We have to make sure that the defense spending is used in the most rational way. Every member state has its own planning, its own ambitions, but we have our responsibilities as the EU. Lithuania, as other member states, have suffered the consequences of the crisis, and the defense budgets went down, but this year and the budget in the next year will already see the defense budget going up. And I think that it'll grow by to the tune of 10% in the next 2 years. Of course, this is not enough to restore the amounts which we had before the crisis, but again, it's good news again that the financing for defense is growing again.
Any more questions? Daugiau klausimų? No? Thank you, Reuters.
Reuters, please.
Thank you. Could you tell us, it's Adrian Croft from Reuters, could you tell us some of the ideas that were discussed for using the battle groups in a more efficient way that you mentioned? Thank you.
Thank you very much. We started this discussion between the five countries who are now involved in the European Baltic groups, and we try to share our expertise, what we achieve in this serving for some months and for the preparation period. And there are two, I think, part of this our experience. One is the military part, how we can improve and cooperation between the soldiers from different countries, and how we can reach the effectiveness and uses of these battle groups. And on the other side is the political decision making. We found that still the decision making process is too long in European Union, and we should be ready to cut this period, to be ready to have more effective use of EU battle groups if it be needed, and if we will reach the agreement between the countries or between the European Union that is needed for a good possibility to use the European Union battle groups. Thank you.
Well, we need to cut the timelines first, and I think it's on everybody's mind that we should improve the usability of battle groups. Potentially, it's a very good tool. We can make it more lean, we can include some additional tasks, but the most important thing is that we should be able to use them whenever and wherever necessary.
No more questions. Thank you very much. Thank you, Minister. Thank you, Deputy Secretary General. Thank you.